Hello and welcome to this new Affinity Publisher tutorial series. Last year, I did a series of YouTube shorts on Affinity Publisher tool by tool, and we went down the left-hand toolbar here in 60 seconds or less. I learned a couple things from that, and one was that 60 seconds wasn't really enough to explain some of these tools. And second of all, because YouTube Shorts are in vertical format, it was hard for people to see what I was doing. So now that we have Affinity Publisher version 2, seems like a good time to just go back to the beginning and just go through the basics. And we're going to go through not only all the tools, but we'll go through all the menus and window items as well. So let's get started with the basics. We're going to go down the left toolbar for starters, and we'll start with the Move tool here in the upper left position. Keyboard shortcut is displayed when you hover over it. It's V. And what the Move tool does is just moves things. So when you have an object, the first thing that will happen when you click on it is that it selects it. So it puts this bounding box around it. Once your object is selected, then you can hold the left mouse button and move it around. So there's the move part of the move tool. You can also grab any of these corner handles, these little dots, and you can scale things in and out. Now, if you want to scale things proportionately, that is, lock the aspect dimensions here, hold shift, and then it will resize in proportion. And then, if you want to just move in a single direction, you can grab one of these dots that are in the middle of any of these sides. And then if you want to rotate, you can go over this pin and hover until you get the double-ended arrows, and then you can rotate around. If you want to rotate in exact increments, you can hold shift, and now it will go in exact 15-degree increments. So it will lock into place as you rotate around every 15 degrees. So that can be useful for a precise rotation. You can also rotate by just hovering over these corners until you also see those double-ended arrows, and then you will also be able to rotate. Hold shift, and you will also be able to rotate in those 15-degree increments. So, to recap, the Move tool allows you to select objects, move objects, scale objects, and rotate objects. Thanks for watching.